Hi guys, very good afternoon. I hope you guys are superb. So welcome to today's class. And now we are moving to which lesson, Mas? Lesson 5, test of divisibility and factors and multiples. And right, last class we discussed about some of the divisibility rule, that is 2, 5 and 10. And right, this 2, 5 and 10. Before going to today's class, dear guys, I want to tell you one thing. Please guys, please finish the last lesson for bending homeworks, because some example already we discussed in YouTube. Remaining in between, I gave 2 or 3 section as homework. Guys, please complete the homeworks and send a snapshot to me, because then only I come to know whether you follow my instructions or not. Okay guys, and also one more thing, if you are interested, please complete the worksheet problem. Lesson 4.3 I gave was a homework on the day. Worksheets. If you can, please complete the worksheet 1, worksheet 2, okay? So, I can't explain everything on this YouTube class. Guys, please discuss, please do by yourself. Whenever you are doing, if you have any doubt, you can ask me, okay? So, exercise 4.1. You already we discussed everything. I thought if you listen the class, you can understand. 4.1 already we discussed. 4.1 we discussed. In between, I gave section 4 as the homework. Again, I am repeating. Again, 4.2 I gave in that section 1 as homework. 2 I discussed. This 2 I already we discussed. And exercise 4.3 I gave as homework. Okay, guys. Please, guys. After this, after watching this class, you do one thing, guys. Finish this at least this three exercise completely, and then take a snapshot and send to me. Okay guys, okay, then well, let's move on to our lesson 5. Okay, last class we discussed up to divisibility rule for 2, 5 and 10. So today we are going to continue with that session. Okay, before going to today's class, just revise what we discussed on our last class. Okay guys. Okay, this is our last class portion. Just we can revise once and we can move to our today's portion. Okay, divisibility rule for 2 and 5. What is the divisibility rule for 2? The last digit is 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0. We can say the particular number is divisible by 2. Again for 5, then the last digit is what, ma? 0 or 5. Again for 10, the last digit is 0. Just recall every day. If you recall like this, you can easily get this concept, and you can easily identify whenever you saw a particular number when which number which is divisible. Okay guys, okay, let's move on to our today's section. Today we are going to see divisibility rule for 4. Okay, please guys, please remember the rules clearly. Okay, so come to divisibility rule for 4. A number is divisible by 4 if the last 2 digits are divisible by 4, or if the last 2 digits are 0. For example, let's move on to the example. Okay guys, example, we can try. I'm going to write a number with the zeros. Okay, 8000. Here, see the second condition. If the last 2 digits are 0, if the last 2 digits are 0, we can tell the number is divisible by 4. So, 8000, last 2 digits are 0, we can tell the particular number is divisible by 4. Okay? These are the some clue words we can easily identify the divisibility. Okay, divisible. What is divisibility? Already we seen. What is divisibility? A number divides the given number exactly without any remainder. Then we can say the given number is exactly divisible by the other number. Okay guys, so here I wrote an example. Always remember, if the last 2 digits are 0, if the last 2 digits are 0, we can at the moment itself we can say yes, this number is sure, it is exactly divisible by 4. Okay guys, next, let's move on to one example. Okay guys, next example, 2560. A number is divisible by 4 if the last two digits are divisible by 4. Here, what's the last two digits? The last two digits is 16. Whether how to check the divisible means how to check. If I am dividing 16 with 4, it gives the remainder as 0 means the 16 is exactly divisible by 4. For example, if I divide 16 divided by 4, if I get the answer as remainder as 0 means we can say 16 is exactly divisible by 4. So that is, see the last now 2 digit is divisible by 4. Here last 2 digit is 16. So we are going to divide the 16 with 4. Okay, 16 divided by 4. Now in 4 table, whether 16 is available or not. Yes, guys. Guys, don't forget to take your notes. Please, whenever I am using this division and all, please guys do along with me in your workout note. Okay. So, let's do 16 divided by 4. In 4 table, how many times 16 is there? Yes, 4 fours are 16. So, 16 by 16, 0. So, it is exactly divisible. So, we can say it is exactly divisible by 4. Let's see one more example, okay? 465. Okay? So, for checking the divisibility rule, we have two conditions. Either the last two number is 0, we can say it is exactly divisible. But here, the last two number is not 0. Two numbers are there. 65. So, let's check whether the 65 is divisible by 4. How to check the divisibility? First, we want to do the last two. Take the last two numbers, 65. 65 divided by 4. Whenever you are dividing 65 divided by 4, if you get the remainder as the 0, then you can say 465 is divisible by 4. So, let's do the division here, okay? 65 divided by 4, okay? So, you whenever start doing, take the very first number, 1, 4 is 4, remainder 2, okay guys? Next, make this 5 as down. Near to 2. So, in whether we can check in 4 table 25 is there? No. But, you know, 5 4s are 20, 6 4s are 24. I'm right. So, you can't take 20. You can use which number? 20 is, 20 is there, 24 is there. Both are less than 25. So, very, very closer. Who is very closer to 25? Exactly 24. I'm right. So, use the 6 here. 6 4s are at the 24 here. So, remainder 1. So, remainder 1. What is the rule of divisibility? Without leaving any remainder, the remainder should be 0. If the remainder should be 0, we can tell exactly this number is divisible by the 4. Okay. So, here you get the remainder as your remainder is 1. So, we can say, so the 465 is not divisible by 4. So, the 465 is not divisible. We can't divide. We can divide, but the thing is, we will get the remainder. Okay, if the remainder, if you get the remainder, so we can't say it is exactly divisible. Okay, guys, see 465 is here. In this 465, take the last two digit, divide by 4, you will get the remainder as 1. If suppose if you get the remainder as 0, we can say this 465 is exactly divisible by 4. Guys, are you clear? Okay, don't get confused. For checking the divisibility of 4, the two conditions are here. What are the very first condition? If the last two digits are divisible by 4, like this you want to check. Or either, if the last two digits are 0. Okay, these are the two rules for divisibility of 4. Guys, don't get confused. Whenever you are learning new divisibility rule, please recall the old one also. Okay, guys? Guys, in divisibility rule for 4, in your textbooks, more example they are giving. Please, guys, please work out that. Okay? So, now we are moving to the divisibility rule for 8. Okay? Let's see the condition. If the last 3 digits are divisible by 8, or if the last three digits are zero. For four, what is the condition? The last two digits are divisible by 4. If the last two digits are 0, here for 8. So just increase 1. Okay, the last three digits are divisible by 8. Or if the last three digits are 0, here same thing. If the last two digits here for 4, listen here one thing. For 4, 2 digit. For 8, 3 digit. For 4, last two digits are 0. For 8, last three digits are 0. Okay? Are you clear, guys? Just simple variation. So, just whenever you are learning, please, guys, please be listen very careful, okay? So, move on to divisibility rule. For example, let's see one example. 6,000. Here the last three zeros. This is the last three digit is zero. We can say the 6,000 is exactly divisible by 8. So let's move on to one more example. Okay. 5,678. Let's move on to the last three. Take the last three digits. The last three digits are divisible by 8. So, how to check divisible? So, you just divide the last three digits, 6, 7, 8, divided by 8. Okay, if you get the remainder 0, we can say this 5,678 is exactly divisible by 8. Okay, let's check this 678 divided by 8. Okay, let's check in 8 table whether 67 is there. We can't take 1 hour because if you take 6 means here 8. So, 8, 6 is smaller than 8. So, take the two numbers together, 67. First, you want to check whether in 8 table 67 is there or not. So, guys, before I want to tell you one thing, again I am repeating. Please, guys, please by heart the table. Okay. So, in 8 table 67 is there. Guys, please just once recall our 8 table. Please tell loudly, my dear guys. Please tell loudly. Yes, please recall it. In 8 table, 67 is there? No. Just, if it is no means, just check the smaller number than 67. It is there, I am right. Which one? 8 into 8 gives you 64. So, 8 8s are 64. Here put 8. 8 8s are 64. 67 minus 64, remainder 3. Then put down this next number, that is 38. Then you want to check whether 38 is there in 8 table. 38 is there. We know 8 5s are 40. So 40 we can't use because 38 is smaller, 40 is bigger. So just see the above number. What is 8 4s are? 8 4s are? It is 32. So we can use this. 8 4s are 32. What's the remainder? 8 minus 2. It is? So, if you get the remainder without leaving any remainder only, we can say it is exactly divisible. So, we here it's leave a remainder 6. So, we can't say this 5,678 is not divisible by 8. Yes, are you clear? Yes. Let's see one more example. 5,488. See the last four number, last three digit, the last, let's divide this last three digit with the 8, okay? Okay guys, 480 divided by 8, so it's leave us a remainder 0. So we get the answer, quotient 61, remainder 0. So we can say this 5,488 is exactly divisible by, by 8. Okay, for 4 and 8, divisibility rule for 4 and 8, a slight change is there. Note the slight change and learn clearly, okay. For 4, 2 digits are divisible by 4 and last 2 digits are 0. For 8, the same thing, the last 3 digits are divisible by 8 or if the last 3 digits are 0. These are the two rules. Please guys, you can easily learn this because a slight change is there, you can easily learn. Okay guys, Guys, take your textbook, page number 82, divisibility rule for 8. In that one box is there. Guys, please take your pencil and underline this. A number ending with a 0 is divisible by 8. Please underline that, guys. Always use pencil in your textbooks, okay, guys? In next, move to our next example. Is 728 divisible by both 4 and 8? What are the condition for 4? And if the last two digit is divisible by 4, we can say the number is exactly divisible by 4. For example, 28 divided by 4 gives you answer 7 without leaving any remainder. So, quotient is 7, remainder is 0. Am I right? So, next move on to 8. Okay, for 8, what is the condition? The last 3 digits is divisible by, let's see the, division here. Guys, you also start doing the division with me. 728 divided by 8. In 8 table, 72 is there. Yes, how many times? 9 into 8 gives you 9 8s are 72. I'm right, guys. I'm 10 8s are 80. I'm right. So 9 8s are 72. So what is the answer? 9 72 0. Next, put on this one. So you will get the remainder 0. So the answer is yes. Okay, guys. Let's move on to the divisibility rule for 3 and 9. Okay. So divisible, a number is divisible by 3 and 9. The sum of the digit is divisible by 3 and 9. Okay, let's see one by one. Okay, first we can check the divisibility of 3. Okay, simple. 3 and 9 is very simple. Very simple. We can see for an example, 3450. So, how to check the sum of the digits? Sum means how to do. Here the question is 3450. So, how to do the sum? How to find the sum of this number? 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 0. What is the answer? 3 plus 4. Guys, please count faster. What is 3 plus 4? It is 3 plus 4, 7. 7 plus 5, it is 12. So, if the sum of the digit should be divisible by 3. We are checking the divisibility of 3. So, is there in 3 table 12 is there? Yes. If I divide 12, if I use 12 divided by 3, you will get the quotient as 4 and remainder as 0. I am right, guys. If you have doubt, guys, please do now itself. What is 12 divided by 3? You will get the quotient as 4 and remainder as 0. So, if it is remainder as 0, we can say this number is divisible by 3. Okay. Let's move on to one more example. 3540. Let's check the divisibility of divisibility of 9. So, first we want to find the sum of this number 3 plus 5 plus 4 plus 0. 5 plus 3, 8. 8 plus 4, it's 12. So, it's 12. Whether, if you divide 12 divided by 9, what you will get as the quotient and remainder? Guys, do fastly and tell the answer. If you do 12 divided by 9, 1 9 is 9. You get the remainder as 3. Remainder as 3, quotient as 1. So, if the remainder, you get there, leaving the remainder 3. So, you guys, you can't tell that it is exactly divisible. So, this number 3540 is not divisible by 9. Guys, are you clear? For 3 and 9 is very simple. Just you do one thing. For 3, you want to add the 3, add the given, do the sum of the given digits. If the given sum of the digit is divisible by 3, we can say it's exactly divisible by 3. The sum of the digit is divisible by 9, we can say the particular number is divisible by 9. Guys, are you clear? Let's see one more example, okay, guys? So, next example, 6,606. Check whether it is divisible by 9. But check if it is divisible by 9 or not. Okay, guys. So 6,606. I am going to check whether this number is divisible by 9 or not. This is my question. So what is the very first step for 993, guys? You remember always, it's very simple. Add the given digit 6 plus 0 plus 6. What is that? 6 plus 6 gives you 12. Again, 12 plus 6, this 18. So if I am divide 18 divided by 9, what do you get the answer? Yes, it's exactly divisible. We can tell, isn't it? Because 9 2s are 18. It leaves quotient as 2 and remainder as 0. So if you have doubt, guys, please do along with me. 18 divided by 9, 9 2s are 18. So 0. Okay? So we can say this 6,606 is divisible, exactly divisible by 9. Okay, are you clear? For 3 and n, very simple, guys. Please show today whatever we seen what under things now. Divisibility rule for 4, divisibility rule for 4 and 8 is similar. 3 and 9 is similar. Okay, guys, please go through the textbook examples. Okay, go through the portions. Please recall, please by heart the table. Okay, guys, so today we are going to end this session. We can meet the next session. Until, take care. Okay, guys, bye bye.